It's time for another Wild Time to let you know what we've been up to. We're at Usery Mountain Regional Park in Mesa, Arizona. It's part of the Maricopa County Park System. There's camping and hiking here, and I think it's probably, what, about 197 degrees right now?
That's what it feels like, but I think it's about 80, but
yeah,
it's pretty warm.
Bad. Yeah.
So, yeah, unfortunately, one thing that we have been doing is being sick, and that's really put us back on the videos that we were hoping to get made. And so, yeah, this flu has been really bad. We got through all of last year without getting sick, but this year everyone around us has been sick, and we kept just fighting it and fighting it, and finally Bernie got it, and then about a week later I got it. Lost my voice completely for about 4 or 5 days. It's starting to come back now, but
yeah,
still sound a little weird, but so
yeah, with all the work projects and then having back-to-back illnesses, yeah. when I got a little bit better and was recovering, then Susan got it, so it really kind of set us back on our video schedule, but we're getting back on top of it now. So we're going to let you know a little bit about what we've been up to otherwise and what we've got coming up.
One place that we went that we really enjoyed was the Wildlife World Zoo and Aquarium in Litchfield Park, Arizona.
Yeah, it's really nice out there. We had a great time. Yeah, it's a little spendy though, huh?
Yeah.
Well, fortunately, my sister picked up the tab on that one. Thanks again, sis. That was very sweet of you.
Yeah, it was a great day. It's a great place. It's huge. They have over 600 species of animals. The aquarium has about, what, 4 or 5 different buildings that you can go
amazing.
In. And just some of the sea life was just incredible. And the place is just huge. I think we got about 7 miles on our Fitbit that day.
Yeah, we walked around quite a bit.
A lot of walking around, but a lot of really neat animals. They have rides there too. And they do have occasionally Groupons for it, or discount tickets that you can get around town that help a little bit with that. But like Bernie said, his sister treated us to that. So that was a really
nice.
Great experience.
Awesome.
Yeah, we had a great day.
Yeah, there's just so much to see there. There was so many animals outside, and we were there, January,
yeah.
So it was actually a little bit cooler.
Yeah, it was a little chilly.
And so a lot of the animals were out, so
yeah.
we got quite a treat. I think there was only, maybe the bear was the only thing
that we didn't get to see,
but it worked out great. It was just a wonderful experience. Lots of animals there, and some of the, like you said, the sea life was amazing. There was just different things that we hadn't seen before or that often, and you know, so we were just kind of, I guess, a little bit amazed at how many things they had there and what they had to offer, because we had heard about it for quite some time and just never made it there. But my sister invited us, so we went along with some more of the family, and we just had a great time.
Great day.
Another thing that we did is go to the Greater Phoenix Hot Air Balloon Festival. Now, this was in January as well, and there's usually 3 going on minimum at that time. One is in Lake Havasu City, Arizona, which we really enjoyed.
Yeah.
We love seeing them over the lake and at the London Bridge there, so that's always a good thing. But this one was actually in Phoenix, and I think there was another one going on the same weekend out in Goodyear.
Yeah,
and we had a pretty good time. We kind of like some of these smaller festivals because we're aware of the large one annually in New Mexico, but we like a lot of these small festivals. We get to spend some time watching the setup and talking with the pilots, and it's a lot of fun
watching them fill up. And the night glow is always really amazing when they light them all up at night. They're just really beautiful. Wasn't as many as they thought were going to be there. There was probably
about over a dozen.
14, 15,
yeah.
And they'd expected over 25. So that was a little disappointing, but the ones that were there were neat, and it was great to see them.
Yeah, we got to watch some flight, but since it was kind of windy, a lot of them didn't go up, but we did get to, like I said, talk to the pilots and watch them set them up and light them up at night, which is always wonderful to see.
Yeah.
So we had a pretty good time.
Yeah. We also attended an RV show in Phoenix. We did a video from there because they had a lot of Montanas, and so we were able to take a look at what the new 2018 Montanas look like. But it was a really kind of interesting RV show.
Yeah, one of the things that was interesting for us was that it was held on the third floor of the building, so yeah. They had to get all those RVs up to the third floor. So I'm sure there's ramps and roads that aren't easily seen, but they get them all in there and get them all positioned just right, and which is basically right on top of each other, right next to each other. But it was kind of interesting.
That was kind of interesting. They had a couple of interesting things there. They had a Class A toy hauler, which is kind of different. Usually the toy haulers are fifth wheels.
Yeah, so three-axle fifth wheels.
We hadn't seen a lot of those. And there was a redwood fifth wheel there that was really beautiful. It had a separate enclosed office space.
Yeah, it was like all glassed in, wasn't it?
It was beautiful. It had its own fireplace and would be really great for someone who has a traveling job and needs a little bit of peace and quiet.
A little more office space than just
a nook. Maybe a little bit more office space, but you know, that's usually, you're lucky if you get a little desk space in an RV.
Right.
So to have a completely separate enclosed office was something that was definitely different.
Yeah, at first I thought it was kind of unusual to have the fireplace in there because I thought, wow, that closes it off from the rest of the place. But I guess it's its own spatial fireplace for just that space, because I guess you could get cold in there.
Another fireplace in the living area, so keep the whole place warm for sure.
Yeah, so that was definitely interesting, but there weren't a whole lot of vendors at this particular show, not what we're used to anyway, but nonetheless, we try to drop in here and there at different RV shows and see
what's out there.
So it was kind of fun. We had a good walk around downtown Phoenix and saw some of the buildings and everything, and it was non-busy. I mean, there was hardly any people around, so that was wonderful.
It was nice.
Well, that's a little bit of what we've been up to. We got so much more in store. Like we said, with the work projects and us both being sick, it really set us back. But we're eager to get to work on some of the videos that we've been promising and a long list that we have coming up over the next few months.
Yeah, we'll be staying in the Southwest for a while longer before we slowly start heading back north.
Yeah, we're eager to do that. We got some good plans coming up for that, so that'll be in the near future. And check us out on our Patreon page and kind of keep in touch there with us as well.
And don't forget to comment, share, and subscribe.
And a thumbs up helps too. Thanks for watching.